We were already using technology in a very similar way. So for our middle school, it wasn't too hard. We all just jumped right in. The question was, how do we keep the element of fun that's so important in middle school? So what we started doing was creating this virtual bulletin board for our middle school, and it was for faculty and students. Greg Moses had his own, you know, section where he would post different mindful activities that students could do or ways to take care of themselves. We had places for DIYs. Kids would post how to make a s'mores snack, you know, and they would post to this website. So then all the kids and all the teachers in the community could visit this website and see all these fun things. I feel like that website is a time capsule for all of the things that we were trying to do to keep community during this. We kept chapel going, which I thought was phenomenal. 3 times a week, 4 times a week, that we would get to see each other and connect in ways that felt pretty normal, regardless of the fact that we were using this new virtual platform.
Our work is, you know, making sure this is a place that includes, you know, people, you know, on every level, which takes intentionality. You know, it takes a lot of hard work, but it's worth it because our students, if you look at them and you hear the quality of their experience, to say, I can just show up and be me. And research shows that, you know, students learn better when they're psychologically safe. Fast forward to May, we began this social justice conversation series. It actually started as lifting up stories that are not being told of those being impacted by COVID-19. You know, we had conversations about what COVID has taught about self, others, and systems. That's kind of what these last couple of months, you know, have looked like for me. Again, it's been a joy to be able to engage the students.
I'm amazed on a daily basis by my colleagues. They just immediately leaned in. No, there was no grumbling. There was no anything, like anything you would expect of normal humans. Like we had to change. We had to do this differently. And every single person just did it with grace and care and love and support of our students. And I was just amazed at the flexibility, the creativity, the work ethic of our faculty.
We got a lot of training and discussions in our faculty meetings about paying attention to how the kids were feeling and their mental health and emotional health. And I would have teachers like in meetings and they would say, like, I can tell something's not right on the other side of that screen. We got to figure out, you know, what's the dynamic that they're learning. And it just impressed me that it's so much more than academics. It was about their just well-being and who they are as an individual. And I think there are some benefits that we saw that you think, oh no, this is gonna go terribly wrong. And it actually helps the student grow and develop.
Being able to transition into this remote learning process, I think, was still something that at the end of the day gave us something instead of just took something away. And that for that, I am very appreciative. The elements and components that come into connecting through music, connecting through art, are the same kind of skills that students need, especially during this time when that one element, connection, is the thing that's being challenged. One of the biggest projects that we took on toward the end of the year was the Beautiful People Project, where students were challenged to find some kind of way to engage in the song or relate to the song Beautiful People by Ed Sheeran and Khalid. And then I took it upon myself to find some creative way to pull all of those elements together in one visual video and release it to hopefully bring some kind of hope and inspiration, not only to our community, but to the world as a whole.
Beautiful people are not always good, but good people are always beautiful.
LA on a Saturday night in summer, sundown and they all come out, Lamborghinis and the rented Hummers, the party's on so they're headed downtown.
Everybody's looking for a come up, and they wanna know what you're about. Me in the middle with the one I'm loving, we're just trying to figure everything out. We don't fit in my just ourselves. I could use some help getting out of this conversation. You look stunning, dear, so don't ask that question here. This is my only fear that we become
beautiful people. Drop top designer clothes, front row at fashion shows. What you do and who'd you know inside the world of beautiful people? COVID news on my phone, prenups and broken homes, surrounded but still alone. Let's leave the party, that's not who we are. We are, we are, we are, we are not beautiful. That's not who we are.
Become.